Good afternoon. It's Connecticut personal injury attorney Ryan McKean here, and I'm here with Connecticut medical malpractice attorney Betsy Ingram. Hi, Betsy.
Hi, Ryan.
Betsy, we're doing our third part in, you know, why we can't accept a medical malpractice case in Connecticut. And, you know, I think this thing we're going to talk about is an especially hard one. And I had a friend who, you know, he went to a dermatologist, they were doing some procedure, and they clearly messed this up. And the result was the friend had a small scar on his face. It was a visible scar. It was definitely there, and they definitely messed up. And I remember the friend, he consulted with some medical malpractice attorneys, and they all said, yep, there was medical malpractice, but we can't take your case. Mm-hmm. Can you explain some factors why, you know, and I think this is a really hard one, and every case is different. So if you're out there and you're wondering if you have a case, you need to know. You need to talk to an experienced malpractice attorney, not just judge it on, you know, a video that you're watching on YouTube. Can you talk about this, Betsy?
Sure. This is a really difficult one. In order for a medical malpractice claim to make sense for everybody involved, for you, for the lawyers, for the courts, for everybody involved, there needs to be a certain level of damages that you have suffered as a result of the malpractice. So it's not enough to just say that the doctor did something wrong and it caused some injury. The injury has to be worth a certain amount of money. And this is not a legal bar, it's just sort of a practical economic reality. The reason for it is that to prosecute a medical malpractice claim against a doctor is really expensive. In order to do that, like we talked about in the first part of our series here, you have to hire doctors to take a look at the records in the case and give their opinions about whether or not there was negligence. And that can cost thousands of dollars, $5,000, $10,000, $15,000, even $20,000 just to review a case and to give their opinions. And so because of that, if your case is only worth $20,000, for example, then all of the money that you might have recovered is going to get eaten up by hiring these doctors to take a look at the records. So you sort of have to look at it as an economic, practical reality, which I know is really hard to hear when you feel like you've suffered an injury and when you've been the victim of malpractice. It's really hard to hear that your injury is not worth it. That's not what we're saying. What we're saying is that there's a real economic reality here that we have to pay doctors to look at this. And if your settlement is just going to get eaten up by doctor's fees, then there really isn't any point putting you through this.
And I think it's especially hard because people may think, like they may hear on TV or through a friend, they have a friend who wasn't that hurt and they got a good settlement in a car accident case, but yet here they are, like my friend who had a scar on his face. Mm-hmm. They can't get any compensation. I think it feels unfair. And I think, I mean, if somebody wanted to really know whether or not their case was economically viable, I mean, we've explained that this is a factor, but can, you know, what, how can they reach you, Betsy?
They can reach me by calling 860-471-8333 or emailing at Betsy, B-E-T-S-Y, at cttrialfirm.com.